Welcome to our new series of Ask the Pastor, where we're trying to focus and concentrate on pressing issues involving the believer and also involving the church. So we thought we will talk to our pastor as usual, Pastor Suresh Ramachandran, who has been very good at this. He has this ministry. We've been doing this in Singala. Now we thought we will start this new series in English. Now today, our topic is going to be attending church. Pastor, thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Roshan, for the wonderful way in which you are welcoming me into this.
It's always a pleasure, Pastor.
Yes.
Well, I thought we should start off with this topic, attending church, because I believe as Christians, most Christians have this question.
Yeah.
Do they have to go to church? Is church essential in their Christian life?
Now, when we become Christians, we become part of a family in which God is our Father. And the Father has stipulated the mandates that His children need to follow. Three of them would be prayer, reading the Word, and attending church. And therefore, as far as I'm concerned, according to the Bible, every Christian must attend church.
Right. Now, there is a thinking, there is always a belief amongst Christians that after all, we are the church.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit of God lives in us. God dwells in us. So if we are the church, what's the idea, what's the need for example, for me to go to church if I'm already the church?
We need to understand the etymology of church in order to find the answer to your question. Now, you may be aware what Jesus said about the gathering. Where two or three are gathered in my name, there am I in their midst. The word he uses is synagoge, the Greek expression. Synagogue in English stems from that. And that is to gather together. But church is an entirely different word, deriving from the two Greek words ek and ekklesia, to come out of. Now you mentioned that we are the church, which is true. The church is not a building, but we, the church, must come in fellowship once a week. And that is what I'm talking about when I talk about church.
Right. So there have been confusion about we being the church. Should Christians go to church? So I suppose we were trying to address those two questions first. Now, my next question is, there are churches and churches, Pastor.
Mm-hmm.
There are the traditional churches with beautiful buildings.
Yes.
And there are also small gatherings in houses.
Mm-hmm.
Now, do you sort of define those small gatherings also as a church, or is it a prayer group? So how do you distinguish between a house gathering and a church?
Now, as I said, the Greek word synagoge is where two or three persons are gathered. Jesus said, if you gather in my name, I will be there in your midst. But when we gather in homes, when we gather as youths, men, women, or exclusive groups of people, that's a mere gathering. Whereas when we talk about an ecclesia, it has an order. There should be a minister, an ordained minister. And
now, ordained by whom, Pastor? Now, there are different people.
Yes.
who are ordaining different, you know, groups and different pastors, different preachers. So who is there a specific style
criterion
or criterion in ordaining?
Yes, because our basic criterion is the Word of God.
Okay.
Now, when the church started in Acts chapter 2, the apostles, who were the disciples of Jesus, they were the ones who actually started the church. Okay, they became the apostles. Jesus had ordained them. Okay, so the ordination started with Jesus. Okay, he started. And then these apostles ordained the other leaders who came or who succeeded them. For example, the very famous Apostle Paul. He, after Jesus called him, he came to Jerusalem, and James, one of the apostles, ordained him. And Paul in turn ordains Timothy by laying on of his hands on Timothy. And then later on he writes to Timothy saying, despise not the anointing you've got by the laying hands of me, the apostle. And from then to now, this criterion is followed. And today, in the 21st century, we have a proper church which is registered, recognized, and there is an official leadership which would follow basic criterions in evaluating the candidacy of this person to become a pastor, and they would officially appoint somebody. That's how a pastor is appointed.
Now, I want to digress, and I want to move slightly away from the topic of attending church. But you said there is an order, and they are established.
Yes.
But I also have heard, and I also know, Pastor, that there are what you call a group of independent churches. Now, how would you look at them? Because they still don't have a proper order, because they're just trying to establish themselves. So you think they can have services, they can have a church on their own?
There is a problem about that, Roshan, all over the world. You know, these independent ministries. Usually, do you know how the independent ministries begin? Somebody breaks away from a recognized church. And then that person is recognized by some believers to be a pastor. And then he very comfortably starts a church. Now, for reasons best known to them, they do that. If they have sufficient solid biblical reasons for starting a church, they can. But they must eventually come into a recognized order of a recognized body, which would then in turn should recognize them.
Pastor, I'm going to put you in a spot here.
Okay.
You need to tell me, how does an ordinary person, how does a believer recognize a good church, a church that he, this is my last question, he or she should go and worship? Now, that is a huge confusion, because as you correctly said, there are churches and churches, there are wrong teachings, and people can get confused. So how would one recognize, what are the characteristics a good church, a church that preaches Jesus Christ should have?
Now I need to ask a question from you.
I'm asking you the questions. You're doing all the answering.
Well, are you talking about a person who is becoming a Christian anew, or are you talking about an already existing believer?
No, I'm talking about someone who needs to go to church. So it could be a mix of both.
Okay.
But okay, somebody goes to a new place.
Yes.
Completely new city.
Yes.
And he's looking for a church.
Yes.
And he needs to identify and understand what church to go. So shall we take that situation?
Yeah, I'll give you two answers. Okay, for the new person who becomes a Christian, I believe the Holy Spirit is involved in this. Somebody becomes a Christian because of the conviction that the Holy Spirit does in that person's inner being. And I believe the Holy Spirit would lead that person to a right church. Moreover, when we preach the gospel to new people, then we must know who is going to do the follow-up. It should be done. For example, if I am preaching the gospel, I need to be accountable over that soul which is going to respond. And I need to make that soul go to a right church. Okay. Now, the second, on the other hand, rather, if somebody is moving away from his or her city into a new place, then he or she must ask his or her pastor to help this person find a better church. Now, for example, many people have moved on from my church into Colombo, to Singapore, to England, to many parts. And I would tell them, let me do the shopping. Why? Because there are so many churches that preach heresy. And it's the responsibility of the shepherd. Okay? Also, I'll give another advice to Christians. If you know of a recognized minister who has a very high standing, a good person with good moral standards, approach that person and obtain an advice as to what sort of a church should they attend.
Thank you, Pastor. I think that was very nice and timely, and I believe it would have educated a lot of people watching us. Thank you for being with us. We certainly look forward to joining you again very, very soon.
Thank you.
Well, we hope you enjoyed that little chat we had about attending church. We tried to touch as to whether a Christian needs to go to church and some of the questions that are involved, some of the issues that are involved in going to church. So that's it today on Ask the Pastor. We'll come back again very soon with another program. Until then, it's God bless you all.